Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're certainly experiencing the true power of sport, right? Just amazing and emotional presentations. Our socially conscious entrepreneur, a new career choice. Our moderator is the former chair of the IOC Athletes from Sport to Business. An entrepreneur, an innovator, and founder CEO of the Sports Innovation Lab. Please welcome to the stage four-time Olympian and gold medalist in ice hockey, Angela Ruggiero. Angela will be in conversation with a true global icon and the father of microcredit and social business. The founder of Grameen Bank and more than 50 other companies in Bangladesh. An honor to welcome here a Nobel Prize Laureate 2006 and founder of Grameen Bank, Professor Muhammad Yunus.
I'm really excited to be here today.
I'm incredibly honored
to interview you, Professor Yunus.
Thank you.
As an athlete myself, someone that cares about athletes' transitions, the former chair of the Athletes Commission, you've done so much in your life. Fortune, in 2012, named Professor Yunus one of the 12 greatest entrepreneurs of our time. That's amazing. But what I like is that you're taking this amazing Nobel Peace Prize background platform that you have, and you're really trying to think about helping the sports movement. So that's what we're here to talk about today. Tell us why sport. Why is sport an area that you really embrace and accept and really want to lend your expertise to?
Well, look at your accomplishment. You're talking about me. I'm nothing.
I'll stop.
Compared to what you have done. I was looking for, as I might do my work, looking for social power. Social power in individuals, social power in corporates, social power in businesses. So that's what drives me, as you mentioned, that 50 companies, all created to bring the social power in business. I call them social business. Business to solve problems rather than make money for yourself. So that has contributed to a lot of things in Bangladesh and outside Bangladesh. Now it's a big subject in Europe and North America, of course, now in Latin America. So as I do that, I'm awed by the power of sports. Every time I look at the sports, it gives me a goosebump, that the power that it has. And I realize that coming from Bangladesh, every time the World Cup comes in, Bangladesh goes into a completely different mode. Every single village of Bangladesh, there are 80,000 villages of Bangladesh, every single village of Bangladesh flying a flag of some unknown country. Most popular flag is Argentinian flag. Imagine people in Bangladesh, in the villages of Bangladesh, who never heard the name Argentina, never know where that is, but they are flying with pride, Argentinian flag. Next popular is a Brazilian flag. And you go down the list. Every country has flag flying from some country, maybe several flags in the same village because they are the supporters. They don't know who they are, what happened, but the celebration that takes place. If their favorite team is defeated, dead silence. Tears down their eyes. Can't talk to each other. What emotional tie you build up globally. I'm talking about only Bangladesh. Imagine what happens to all over the world when every game is played, everything. You pour in your heart behind your favorite team to support. That emotion, that power, is not used for social purposes generally. Generally, it is for entertainment, which is good. And sometimes it's also a business opportunity for people to promote their product and so on and so forth. But the social part is missing. So that's what I was complaining. And President Thomas Bach heard me speak on that subject. So he invited me to come to Lausanne. Why didn't you explain what you feel about the social aspect of sports to our audience in Lausanne, our IOC? And I spoke to them, answered their question. Then he invited me to come to Rio during the Olympic. And I was invited to speak to the Olympic Committee. And I did that. Immediately, his made an impact. Everybody understood. Maybe we can use that. That's the relationship I built up, and I became a torch
bearer. So you're a believer. Everyone in this room loves the Olympic movement. We're here to talk about Olympism in action, the values of the Olympic movement, excellence, friendship, respect. You understand that through the lens of social impact and what it does for communities. Now let's pivot a little and talk about what this same philosophy can do for athletes. Because we see the performance that athletes are doing to inspire the world on the field of play, but off the field of play. Professor, what do you think, you know, why are athletes could benefit from this philosophy, this entrepreneurship philosophy, this philosophy of helping them when they pivot into life after sport?
I looked at it from the social power of the sports, not only for the athletes themselves, also for the rest of the world. The same power applies to themselves. And I started looking at the sports world, and you see there are lots of things their social orientation can change that. For example, sports life is a very short life to begin with. By 35, you're done. You go down and you start. You have to start a new life. And you pour in your heart, your energy to pursue a particular goal, to win. Win, win, win. And after that, maybe you're successful, maybe you're not as successful as you hoped, maybe you're as successful as you are right now. But not everybody is lucky enough to go that far. So down the line, there are many failures, many, where do they go, where do they start? And I said, look, this is an opportunity for, again, using your social power. Transform them into entrepreneurs. Searching for a job at that age is not an easy job because you never did any job. You're totally devoted to your sports. So turn them into entrepreneurs. You become an entrepreneur by yourself, but not everybody's again lucky as like you. So what do they do? Particularly people who have not gone to the top of the sports world, mid-level, low-level, even fail at the ground level. Where do they end up? So we can create institutions, policies, programs so that turn the sports people into entrepreneurs after you complete it, even when you're failure coming off the track in the middle of it, turn them into entrepreneurs. Yeah. And basically what I do, I believe in all human beings are entrepreneurs, irrespective of where you are from, what kind of educational background, or what kind of family background you have, doesn't matter. Human beings basically are entrepreneurs. That's in our DNA. Simply we are pushed into doing work for somebody else called job seeking. I said, job is not the ultimate of human being. So we encourage, this sports world gives me an opportunity to demonstrate that. We have been doing it in Bangladesh, asking unemployed young people to start businesses. We create a social business venture capital fund and ask them to come with business idea. We become investor in their business. We become their partner. Make it successful. As you're successful, return the money we gave you. We're a social business. We are not interested in making profit out of you. So you move on, and we move on with investing in others. So thousands and thousands of young people come, and we invest in them. Same thing can be applied in a sports person, for athletes, any world.
But I love that because, again, we talk a lot about, and you heard it in the Women's Sport Commission discussion earlier, the athlete has a certain mindset. They have intangible skills that they take that with them for the rest of their lives. They learn perseverance, goal setting, teamwork. They learn, you know, performance in the clutch. They learn all these really valuable mindset skills. They may not have the skill set, but they certainly understand how to compete. And what you're doing now is thinking about how do we give them that skill set? How do we actually take this incredible mindset that athletes possess and enable them when they retire to go on and be successful? And is that really the spark that you saw
Absolutely.
In Olympians? That they are why they're great hires for business? Why, you know, that was why I started a company. I said, I could use everything that I've learned on the field of play, on the ice, and literally build the team around me, set a goal for them. And to me, gaining that skill set at business school is really important. But you're now through Athlete 365, the business accelerator that will soon launch here today.
Today, right after.
Tell us what we're doing with the IOC.
Absolutely.
The Athletes Commission, the WOA, the World Olympians Association thought of this, but you're really taking it to the next level with the IOC. Tell
Absolutely.
Us about that program.
This is what we're going to do. Bring this idea, and you don't have to complete your sports life to start this process. It will be simultaneous process. As you continue in your athletic life, and athletic life is about determination, about hardships, about winning. That's a key word for the winning. And that's very essential in whatever life you want to take. The winning part that drives you, goal-driven, and you want to make it happen, make it successful. You bring it to another world, to the business world and make it happen. So what we'd be doing, we'd take these young people in the athletic world, those who are already finished their sports life or they're in the beginning or the middle stage, we'll talk to them, give the idea that, look, when you are finished with phase one of your life, you have to begin a phase two, these are the options you have. And we'll tell them and prepare them as you go, so that there is no discontinuity.
Yeah.
You smoothly move into it, and we'll invite you, entrepreneurs, who, sports people who became entrepreneurs, inspire them.
Mentor.
Absolutely. That's what we'll be doing.
No, this is great, because again, the Athletes Commission on the IOC has spent many years thinking about the career transition. And most athletes, I'm sure, get asked, are you going to coach? Are you going to broadcast? You know, maybe you'll go be a manager.
Yeah.
And yet we have this mindset to be entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
And you're really, you saw that spark.
Absolutely.
You're enabling it through the Athlete 365 Business Accelerator Program beyond that.
Absolutely. Most of the time they become misfit because they're not used to working for somebody. They're late in starting the career. Already their same age friends are ahead of the game. They're starting from the beginning. So they look like misfit. Here you are at the beginning. You are the boss of yourself. You do your things the way you want. And that's how you start your life with dignity. Not only people who are in the process of finishing their sports life as a mid-level success, low-level success, also the top-level success.
Mm-hmm.
They have their problem too. You are the celebrity, everybody is thrilled to take a selfie with you, but then what? Gradually people forget about you, and you get very, very frustrated that, what do I do with my life? Your whole life is waiting for them. We go with them. Said you can become a very successful entrepreneur. So start where you're at the top, and be a big business out of here. And we give all the options and give the ideas about social business. They can do so, lots of social business. Today, athletes, when you're successful, when you're celebrating, you start earning money by using your voice, your face, to promote a commercial product. It could be a watch, it could be shoes, whatever product. Just because you wear it, your friends, millions of your friends want to do that.
Yeah.
So this, you have a big power. So we can transform, we can also use that power to transform the life of the world, people's world, so that you can say, oh, I love social business.
Mm-hmm.
Suddenly everybody can say, what is social business? My big...
No, this is great because again, athletes have a voice through social media.
Absolutely.
And digital technology. They go direct to consumer. They can tell you what they think.
Exactly.
They embody brands now. They embody sponsors or the Olympic movement, the NOC, the Federation. They are a reflection of that.
Sure.
But what you're saying is, let's not just think about how to use them, but how to support them.
Absolutely.
In their afterlife from sport.
And successfully.
Yeah.
And you feel good that you're using your power in transforming the society around you. Because
I'm an athlete, and
yeah.
I say, I have a cause that I really care about.
I need
to build something.
Absolutely.
What do I do?
Well, I would tell my friends, uh-huh. I don't like smoking.
Yeah.
It hurts you.
Mm-hmm.
Just one word. Imagine the impact it makes.
Yeah.
I don't like sugary drinks.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody's, hey, why am I doing that? All kinds of things, simple messages.
So feel from your heart. The three stages, I just have to talk about Athlete 365 real quick. There's going to be a digital platform now. You can go online, learn about entrepreneurship in general, and this is open to all athletes. The next phase is if you're really interested in building this business, maybe it's a campaign or a foundation around,
sure.
You know, to quit smoking. There'll be further mentorship, and if you really succeed and want that close personal relationship through this new partnership with the Yunus Foundation,
lots
you can
of
apply
it.
For that.
Lots of it.
Yeah.
Lots of it. This is individual sports person I'm talking about. Imagine the power of the clubs,
everyone.
Sports club. Club itself represents, again, emotions from the neighborhood, your supporters, all there. If you want to take an initiative in social direction, how powerful it can get. Federations, imagine the power of the federations in respective places, wherever you work. You have a social dimension that you can play in your city, in your neighborhood. You can transform your neighborhood just by giving the leadership. Because you have the power of inspiring people.
Yeah.
You're not using that. I said, use that power. You got it. And it can be any kind of sports formation. Because sports is so emotional tie with individual people. Use this emotion to transform the society around you. Things that you don't like in your neighborhood. Things that you want to change in your neighborhood, in your city, in your country. In the world that you live, you have that power.
Thank you, though, for taking a step back, using the platform that you have, partnering with the IOC to build this. Want to thank Olympic Solidarity. They're going to continue to fund this and really help take it into the future. But you've recognized that athletes are more than athletes. Athletes are people. Athletes have this amazing skill
set. Powerful people, not just
powerful
people.
Powerful people with a voice.
With a voice.
They have a powerful voice. And the fact that you've carefully thought about this, I mean, you're a Nobel Peace Prize winner. You can do anything. You're continuing to give back and support athletes.
Every individual can do anything they want. You don't need a Nobel Peace Prize winner to do that. That's the power of individual.
You should be a coach, I think. You should.
Thank you.
Professor Yunus, thank you for what you're
thank
doing.
You.
Thank you for being a part of the Olympic movement, Olympism in Action.
I'm delighted.
For continuing to give back.
I feel very privileged that you have given me a chance to be associated with the sports world. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Angelo Ruggiero, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Professor Yunus. Please stay with us.
Thank you.
As we now ask the President of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bach, to join us on the stage along with Professor Yunus to sign the Memorandum of Understanding.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you.
As we sign this MOU, this has certainly helped to set the stage for many athletes around the world. And this new program, along with the International Olympic Committee and the Yunus Foundation, launching here today at the Olympism in Action Forum. So we are witnessing now a very historic moment, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, congratulations. And we look forward to the athletes of the world greatly benefiting from this joint program. So if you can now turn around the memorandum for the world to see, Professor President Bach. The signing of the MOU, ladies and gentlemen. Yunus Foundation, International Olympic Committee. Congratulations to all. Professor Muhammad Yunus, thank you for being here with us. Thank you, Professor.